What's up, y'all? It's BK back with Muscle Up. If this is your first time on my channel, thank you for clicking on this video. If you're a fan of fitness, cars, and life in general, go ahead and do me a quick favor. Hit like, subscribe, turn on those notifications, and then go check out my other videos to play catch up. Like those videos as well, and also let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you're returning, thank you. I really appreciate the support, and I'm glad that you all are loving what you see. Also, don't forget about my giveaway. I will be doing a giveaway of a $50 gift card plus a free Muscle Up hoodie once I reach 100 public subscribers. Remember, your subscription must be public. That's the only way I can see you. That's the only way I can count you. But yeah, I'm sure you all saw the title of today's video. I'm going to be doing a review on the training mats, and I'm talking about this right here. And if you've seen my workout videos thus far, you have pretty much always seen me with this on. I rarely take it off, if ever. But yeah, not only am I going to be talking about this one, I'm going to be talking about where it all started for me, which was with this one right here, the Training Mats 2.0. Now, I've had this one, which I never use anymore, for about 7 years now. And here's a quick photo of me with it on 7 years ago. But the company Training Mats itself has been around for about 10 years now, and it started with the Training Mats 1.0, and here's a picture of that one. Now, I had no idea and no knowledge of Training Mats when they came out, which is why I didn't own that one, and to be honest, I wouldn't want to, just the way, because of how it looked. But once I did learn about Training Mats, I purchased the latest edition at the time, which was this one, the Training Mats 2.0, which just had a more simplified and a cooler look. Now, supposedly, and I'm sure that you all see three different masks up here, the jury and science is still out on these, so please do your own research. But wearing the training mask consistently during exercise supposedly helps strengthen your respiratory muscles and also helps you improve your oxygen capacity of your lungs. And if you're an athlete of any kind, you know how important it is to have a high oxygen capacity to help you endure strenuous activity, or simply put, help you with your endurance. And it does this by placing your body in a hypoxic, which means low oxygen state, causing your body to adjust to this state and breathe more efficiently after common usage. So the 2.0 uses a valve system in which it uses these things called flux valves, and these go right inside of here, and also resistance valves, and I'm sure that you see the other two here. Now, these two items will control the intensity that you would place yourself in, and depending on how you configure your mass, as you see there are multiple resistance valves here, that will control the level of intensity that your mass would be at that certain time. Now, you would either have to memorize these configurations or have the chart that the company provided, which would tell you which configuration provided which level of intensity. And to be honest, I wasn't a fan of this. I used this mask the least because of this, actually, but the 2.0 was cool for the time being, and it also had cool mask sleeves. And I know all of my Batman fans know that this is an image of Bane's mask. So this was some good thinking on behalf of Training Mats and some great marketing as well. I'm sure that they partnered with DC to be able to use those images. But yeah, some definitely great marketing on behalf of Training Mats. With that being said, let's move on to Training Mats 3.0. And I can say this is my second favorite of the three masks you see here. But yeah, 3.0 was a huge upgrade simply because of their dial system, which you see here. You can also see that little valve in the background moving as well. And also because of the flux valve, this little black circle that you don't have to change to get a different configuration. And this still provides 6 levels of intensity and simply requires a turn of this dial to change that level of intensity. So once again, a huge upgrade simply for ease of use. And they also kept it up with the cool sleeve designs. And this was actually another Bane sleeve design here. That I've actually just washed the hell out of this sleeve, but they have numerous others such as like Sub-Zero, Venom, things of that sort. But yeah, big fan of the 3.0, although I don't wear it now. Now, the reason I'm not wearing that one anymore is because I'm wearing this one, and this is the Training Mats Vent Edition. And I'm not wearing this simply because of the difference in external design, but more so because of the internal difference. I'm gonna take this cap off and also lift this cage up. Now, this still goes by the flux valve system. However, it has a filter in here that is 99% particulate certified, meaning it should capture 99% of all particles and pollutants, things of that sort. Now, that is huge right now for me due to COVID. Now, I'm not saying this is 99% effective against COVID, and neither will I state that Training Mats would say that either. But right now in this day and time, I'd rather have some protection than none at all against COVID.
and this also provides very similar levels of intensity just as the 3.0 does, as it also has the dial system. And you can see how this open and closes the vent, basically. But it's really cool design. I think it's a really effective design. And you also use the same sleeves from 3.0 on this training mass vent edition. So that's another really cool thing. And it's also really easy to clean. I usually just take an alcohol wipe, and wipe on the inside of it where all my breathing and spit and all of that stuff flies. And also the cap as well, and the internals by the flex valve and also up under this cap. So, or cage, should I say. But really simple and easy to clean as well. So with that being said, out of all of my years of experience from owning these now, and I've owned these two more so specifically just about a year now, I can honestly say that all of them have improved my breathing during exercise and cardio. And I can say 100% that this one has improved my confidence and safety concerns when it comes to working out in the gym. When I do intense cardio sessions, I do take this off, and I can tell the difference of my increased endurance and of how I breathe during those sessions. So I got to give a big shout out to Training Mass for these inventions as a whole, and especially for the vent edition. Definitely thank you all for this training mask.
But that'll do it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I figured it was time that I finally did a review on the training mask, as I said I would in the previous video. And I've also had several people ask me about it, both in the gym and those that have seen my videos as well. But definitely wanted to do a review on it. I'm not compensated by training mask in any way, but training mask, if y'all want to talk business, holla at your boy. But that'll do it for today's video. If you haven't already, like this video, subscribe to my channel, let me know your thoughts and comments below, and also turn on those notifications. And also, don't forget about my giveaway. Once I reach 100 public subscribers, I will be giving away a $50 gift card and this fresh Muscle Up hoodie. Now, not this one exactly, this is mine, but I have other brand new ones that I haven't been touched. But I'll be giving away that once I reach that 100 subscribers. But share this video. And with that being said, be easy, be safe. See y'all soon.